Hey, what's going on, guys? Clickwood here, back again, bringing you guys another Madden 16 Draft Champions video. Guys, you're going to be watching all of the games from this whole Draft Champions series that I played. Very first thing that we're doing is picking the team here, and obviously this is our first option here. We have to choose between, you know, getting an Adrian Peterson, getting a Rob Gronkowski, getting a Le'Veon Bell. I decided to go with Rob Gronkowski just because my offensive play style, I kind of need a little bit of a speedier running back typically, and I understand Adrian Peterson is very good, but typically they do give you some additional options at running back, so I decided to go with Adrian Peterson. Here we go with George Iloka because we want that height. Try and take away the deep ball if we can. Hopefully that'll work out for us. Jamie Collins here, another elite player on defense, trying to stack up the defense just a little bit. And then here we decide to go with a quarterback. Joe Flacco's got a big arm, obviously, so being able to throw the deep ball if we need it is a great thing, obviously. Now here, another decision had to be made. I don't really like Eddie Lacy because of the slow speed, and I already had a quarterback, so I don't think Tony Romo was in the running. We already had a tight end too, but you know what? Having Jimmy Graham and Rob Gronkowski, I think that could potentially work out for us. So let's see what happens with that. We end up picking LeSean McCoy here as our running back. Wasn't super excited about that. I wish that I could have found somebody with a little bit more speed. 88's not terrible, but it's not really great either. It's hard to get around the edge with that, so I wasn't super excited about it. Right here, though, I make one of my favorite picks. I always like to take Vontae Davis if I have the opportunity to. I know most people would have probably taken Dez Bryant there, but to me, I just think getting a cornerback to match up with those receivers is so very, very important as we take another linebacker there. And then here, we're going to take a wide receiver. We're going to take DeAndre Hopkins, who I think has a lot of the attributes that Dez Bryant does. He's not quite as good, but still pretty darn decent and a decent enough option for us to take as our number one wide receiver. Another linebacker there. So we take three linebackers here, all of them left outside linebackers. But you know what? At the end of the day, you can change it around a little bit. So I wasn't too worried about that. Very, very happy with having good linebackers at least. And then here we end up getting a flashback pull. We've got an option between Ted Ginn Jr., Santonio Holmes, or Brandon Marshall at wide receiver. I decided to go with Santonio Holmes because I kind of think he's the best combination between all of them. He's basically a better version of Ted Ginn if you look at like the speed and that kind of stuff. So I decided to go with Santonio Holmes there. Brandon Marshall, again, just a little bit too slow for me. And then right here, we get my favorite running back of the past, I don't know, ever since Emmitt Smith retired. We get LaDainian Tomlinson, and I had to look around at the other guys. Walter Jones is obviously in consideration because he's probably the best left tackle in the game. I think he is right now, if I remember correctly. You guys can correct me in the comments section if you know differently. Ray Lewis, obviously, also a big-time leader on defense, but I decided to go with LaDainian Tomlinson here because, you know, again, he's my favorite running back. So we've got now LaDainian Tomlinson, who's got plenty of speed, a little bit of an upgrade from LeSean McCoy, who we had before, but hey, McCoy can also find some place on the team and get out there on the field from time to time. So, very first play against my opponent here, and he is going to complete a huge pass here over the middle. Massive, massive gain, and we just completely fell apart. We missed a tackle. It just was not anything good there.
Get over here.
But a couple of plays later, we get a beautiful interception there. Hey, it wasn't a user pick, but I will definitely take it. And then we get pulled down by an offensive lineman, a heel clicker. You got to be kidding me that he caught our cornerback there. Ah, it's those silver corners, man. It's those silver corners. But hey, we do have the football. Third and three here. We got to make a play, and we are going to find Jimmy Graham out here in the flats making the play there. We've got, again, Jimmy Graham and Rob Gronkowski. We're playing Jimmy Graham actually at fullback, making him a valued asset for us. He's a good blocker, and he also can make plays out of the backfield. And then we catch Santonio Holmes here on a quick outside pattern there for the touchdown. Up 7-0 here on the first drive, and then we're going to go back on defense here, trying to make some stops here. And my opponent's kind of beating us up with the running game right now as he makes a nice run there up the middle with his back. And then on this play, it's 1st and 10. He's going to take it right up the middle. We see it coming. Bam, son! Lay the hammer on him, but he does recover the fumble there. Huge hit, though, by HaHa Clinton Dix. Unfortunately, George Iloka gets beat here on the deep pattern. I believe that was to his tight end. I don't know, man. That's just so ugly. Pissed me off when he completed that, but hey, what are you going to do? And he does make a nice completion here. Tony Romo kind of dissecting us on this drive now, but we get a huge sack there right before the end of the 2-minute warning. Now, it's actually 4th and goal here. My opponent's got the ball at the 15-yard line, looking to score here before the end of the first half. Probably should have taken his 3 points. We drop everybody into coverage. I end up deciding to use our pass rush there, and then he ends up throwing it into coverage, double coverage there. We didn't get the interception, but it was actually probably a positive that we didn't get that pick, and then we're going to throw the ball off our back foot, get completely lucky there. I can't even lie. That should not have been a completion. Probably should have been intercepted. But hey, we got to get some luck eventually. You know what I'm saying? It's always feeling like I have such terrible luck. But you know what, man? We get some good luck there on that drive. Do get a huge completion. And then we're back to the running game here with LaDainian Tomlinson, taking advantage of his bad defensive user skills there. And the back juke there by Tomlinson nearly breaks it for a touchdown, but he's taken down from behind. And we've got 38 seconds left here in the first half before my opponent ends up deciding to quit there. So we do get the W here in the first game. Three more wins here to move on to our championship. And man, that first game gave me quite a bit of confidence. I felt pretty good about it. I think we played pretty darn well in that one. Definitely got a little bit lucky, but also forced him into some bad mistakes there as well. And took advantage of some bad defensive plays that he continued to run. And we really just kind of dissected him. And we get the user pick there. Gotcha, bitch. The interception there. And man, we're looking pretty darn good right now as my opponent. Oh my gosh, he commits on the run. And Flacco just sails it over DeAndre Hopkins' head. Thankfully, though, the running game is looking pretty good right now. LaDainian Tomlinson doing some work here. And we find a receiver off the back foot. Joe Flacco, big, big pass there. And then the very next play, LaDainian Tomlinson gets the blocks that he needs. And he is going to break a tackle and get into the end zone. A 6-0 lead here early in this football game. And that is all that my opponent wanted to see. He got an interception against him, and then he allowed a touchdown. So we do get the W here as well. Forced two rage quits already early in our games. Didn't even make them to halftime. So feeling pretty good about that. Our chances are looking better and better with every game that we do. Nice completion there on the first play of the third game here. And again, back to the running game. LaDainian Tomlinson, just an absolute freaking monster. Again, my favorite running back to use back in the old Madden days. And look at him go here, breaking off for another huge game, breaking another tackle there before he's finally taken down. Back to the passing game here. That pass was working so very, very well for me, both against man and zone coverage. And we hit it up again right here to DeAndre Hopkins. It's consistent. It got us decent yardage just about every single time. And check this one out. Over the middle, Rob Gronkowski on the slant pattern into coverage. Sets us up here with first and goal here at the goal line, and we are getting in here. LaDainian Tomlinson, touchdown one more time. That quick toss is so very, very difficult to stop. Whether you're a computer or a user, it's very, very difficult to stop. You pretty much have to commit on stopping it, and that, if you do that, will allow the opposing team to pass all over you in a lot of situations. So doing very, very well with our offense, mixing things up and, catching him off guard with the run and the pass. My opponent's definitely doing pretty well on this drive, though. He's looking pretty good here as he picks up a nice chunk of yardage there. But it is now 4th and 3, and my opponent's going to run a screen pass here, and we actually usered that before the play began. I put that guy into man coverage, so that worked out pretty darn well for us on that play. Back on offense now, and LaDainian Tomlinson just squirting around the edge there. He's so difficult to get because he's just quick, and he's strong, and he's physical, and everything that you want in a running back. Definitely my favorite running back that I've used so far in this game. 3rd and 6 here, and we're back to the passing game. Oh, we had a man there, but they got through on the pass rush there. Now it is 4th and 6. And unlike my opponent in the last game, I am going to take my 3 points here before the end of the first half. So we do get a 10-0 lead here. That actually almost missed. That was very, very close. I thought that I got a lot more on that than I apparently did. So we got kind of lucky there. Tried to user that one coming out of the second half here, but he just decided to throw it right at me anyway and got the nice completion there to his tight end. So he's moving the ball fairly effectively here with Arian Foster. The running game is definitely working for him, but we do make a nice play here, pushing him back for more and more yardage. He ended up actually losing 5 there on 2nd and 1, excuse me. Sets up now a 3rd and 6, and bam! Another huge hit, but he recovers it again. Lucky, lucky, lucky with those fumble recoveries right now. 4th and 5, and my opponent is going to try and go for this one, but he does take another sack. We set the outside contain there, and it worked out for us. Now DeAndre Hopkins getting things going here in the passing game on offense, trying to go up 3 scores here if we can, and it's looking pretty good as we hit up Santonio Holmes here, and he is not going to be caught as he gets into the end zone. Flashback Santonio Holmes for the touchdown there. My opponent's got to go deep here. We know he's got to go deep. He nearly completed that one, though, into coverage. That would have pissed me off. 4th and 10 here, and he's looking down the field again, throwing it. Oh, man, on the run. Big play there for him. Could have been the end of the game right there if he did not convert there, but he did convert. 2nd and 10 here, and my opponent's going to go deep here into coverage. Vontae Davis tried to swat it away, but could not get his hand on it. An aggressive catch there for a huge completion. Next play, we do see the screen pass coming and we are able to stop it, so he only picked up three there. Give a fuck about your feelings. Give a fuck about your feelings. And yeah, we are going to lay the hammer on that one. Finally, we recover a fumble. That is going to end the game as my opponent does decide to quit. So we end up now in our championship game right here, Draft Champions Stadium, and we match up against a guy who the night before absolutely destroyed me with this blitz that he was sending. It was ridiculous. And you guys are going to get a chance to see this here on the first play. He is pretty much nano blitzing me. Now, I'm not going to say that it's a cheese play or anything like that, but dude, he is sending so much pressure that I have no idea what to do. Sets up now a 3rd and 10 here, and we're trying our best here. We've got guys, and they're dropping passes, man. DeAndre Hopkins dropping passes. They're 0 for 3. Sets up now a 4th and 10, and the reason that I go for it here is because I know that this guy's offense is really, really good, or it was against me last night, and I just figured I had to score on every single opportunity that I had. We do not get the conversion, though, unfortunately. So we're in a really tough situation here now as we give up the huge run here. Brings up now a 1st and goal from the goal line. My opponent already looking to take the lead here, but we make a nice stop here on the run. Sets up now a 2nd and goal. So we've got an opportunity here. We just have to make a stop. If we can make one stop here, I feel like we're going to have an opportunity potentially. We just need to not give it away on the first drive. And bam, we get the user interception. Huge pick there. Absolutely gigantic at the goal line. We end up having to take the ball at the 1-yard line, though. Very, very dangerous with this guy's defense, because look at the blitzes that he is running. They're getting in there so, so ridiculously fast. I don't even know what to do. I'm trying to block, guys. It's just not working out. But thankfully, we did convert there on a pass, and then we are going to run here, setting up a 3rd and 3, and we get the conversion here. LaDainian Tomlinson just using his strength to continue running and picking up the first down there. 2nd and 11 here, and we're looking down the field. Oh, but we threw it right to him. An excellent interception there by my opponents. I've got to give him credit. He made a great play there. He really, really did. And then the very next play, he throws it up into traffic, and we just cannot stop it. Haha, Clinton Dix, no match for Julius Thomas on that one. And then he is going to step into the end zone here with his running back. An easy touchdown. Very, very frustrating that we were not able to stop that regressive catch. But you know what? It happens. We've got to make sure that we come back, though, in this game. We cannot go down 2 scores against this guy. He's just too good. He killed me the other night, man. I have not been beaten like that in this game yet by anybody. So we are going to continue, though, to go for it here on 4th downs. I'm going for it every single time against this guy because, again, his offense is really, really good. But this time we are going to take advantage of the fact that he blitzed. I waited until his user got past the tight end, and we hit Rob Gronkowski on the streak for the touchdown. He is not able to be brought down from behind. So awesome, awesome play. We're tied here. Going down with only 30 seconds left. We tip the ball up. He tried to aggressive catch it again, and we get the interception there. Huge. We've got a chance here to potentially even take the lead before the end of the first half. And look at LaDainian Tomlinson finding his way through the defense, breaking tackles, picking up massive yardage there. We're at the 44-yard line here on 2nd and 7, and we're going to go deep here over the middle. DeAndre Hopkins, again, a huge catch down to the 32-yard line. We just want to bring it into a potentially closer field goal here, and we do exactly that. Setting up the field goal at the 20-yard line, a very makeable one, and we do it right before the end of the half. So 10-7 going into the half. My opponent gets the ball coming out. Could have been very disastrous given the fact that we turned it over on the first drive, but it wasn't. And he's going to try and go for the aggressive catch here, but Dikembe Mutombo, aka Vontae Davis, is able to swat that one away, and we are going to be able to stop it once at least. Next play, though, Julius Thomas just too fast for the defense. Jamie Collins just could not keep up with him. I thought for sure we could keep him in single coverage. That was not the right decision, though. John Elway finds Julius Thomas for the touchdown. Very, very disappointing for our defense as we give up the lead now, 14-10. 3rd quarter here, middle of the 3rd quarter, 3rd and 5, and we are stopped. Brings up another 4th down. We've got to go for it. We just have to. Again, I keep saying that, but we have to. And right here, look at this touch pass by Joe Flacco. Amazing throw there by Joe Flacco. Santonio Holmes left open, and we are going to score the touchdown here. That fade route slant thing. I don't even know what the hell you want to call that, but it was huge for us. We will definitely take it as we get the lead back here. Third and 13 after that pass there that lost him yardage, and he is going to find his tight end again. Julius Thomas over the middle. We just cannot defend him. He is just single-handedly destroying us at this point. I'm doing my absolute best to try and chip him when I can. It is just not working out, and he is going to find him yet again. Waiting. We just cannot get any pressure on Elway, and he is able to convert there. Another nice throw. Trying again to stop Julius Thomas, do everything that we can. We took that pass away that time, forced him to take the sack there. Now, second and 14, he is going to take another sack here, bringing up now a third and 22, and where is he going to go? Where do you think he's going to go? Another aggressive catch. Julius Thomas is just destroying us. 3 minutes left in this game, and my opponent then continued to run out the clock. So there's less than 2 minutes left in this one on second and six, and I'm starting to use my timeouts. I've got to make sure that I get the ball back, so if he has to kick a field goal, I have a chance to potentially win this thing. But man, it is very, very nerve-wracking right now as John Elway takes on three defenders, somehow doesn't fumble there. First and goal here, and my opponent's going to take the ball up the middle. Big play there by the user play. We make the tackle. Setting up now a second and goal. Again, I'm getting real, real nervous right now as he hands the ball off on a reverse. I was definitely not expecting that. DeSean Jackson on the reverse. I don't know if he was just trying to grind out more clock or what. But on third and goal here, we're sending nothing at him. We're sending and nothing. Oh my gosh, he almost completed that thing. We almost got the interception. Fourth and goal here. And where is he going? Julius Thomas. And we get the user pick. Gotcha, bitch. A massive, massive interception there. Unbelievable. The timing on that interception could not have been any better. We get two user picks in this game in the end zone, and LaDainian Tomlinson's gonna let him hear about it as he breaks a tackle, and he is off to the races for a touchdown here. We're already up three, gonna go up two scores here with less than 30 seconds left in this game. Let him hear about it, LT. Let's go, baby. We're gonna walk away with the W here. Draft champions here in this one. I am absolutely loving it. I can't believe that we won this game. I got so lucky numerous times, but hey, we definitely need luck sometimes to walk away with W's. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, do me a favor, hit that like button and subscribe to the channel if you're new. I know this was kind of a longer one than what we normally do, but hey, I wanted to bring you guys something long and something interesting. I haven't done a whole lot of gameplay here on Madden 16. So again, I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I'm not acting like I'm the best Madden 16 player in the world, but I had a lot of fun doing this Draft Champions series. So if you guys want to see more of it, let me know in the comment section below, and I will definitely provide that for you guys. So thanks again. Talk to you again soon. Hope you enjoyed it. Hit that like button, subscribe, everything like that, and watch these highlights here as we end the video. Thank you guys. Bye-bye.